Ambulance service, is the patient breathing?
We don't know, it's a big accident on Kingsway.
Big car crash.
He's just come really fast. I was in the back garden and I heard
Okay, listen to me so I can get some help. How many people are hurt?
I think there's two. I think one.
I don't know, There's crowds around it.
He's just hit a pole.
Right, so what, he's hit a pole?
Thanks, 498. I'm going to dive with you to a Cat 2 in Didsbury. Male running to a lamppost.
The crew divert from the one-year-old baby to the road traffic collision 3 miles away. The only doctor-led air ambulance covering Manchester is also dispatched.
It's a hard one, isn't it? Because we haven't got that much information in there which is saying this is a definitely serious injuries, but 6 calls for it on a fast road, with some saying serious bleeding, some saying trapped. It's probably a reasonable send, isn't it?
With the air ambulance dispatched, advanced paramedic Gary is also en route, along with 3 police cars and 2 fire engines.
They're trying to get him out of the car now.
They're trying to get him out of the car.
We would advise not to.
Okay. No. Leave him in. Leave him in the car.
What are they doing?
Okay, what's happening? Tell me what's happening.
It doesn't look like they can get him out.
You're doing a bad way.
Didsbury.
Are they all the same job?
It's all the same job.
I just had a quick look over there. There's like about 10 duplicate jobs, isn't there?
In control, calls are stacking. The number received per hour has doubled since the start of the shift. Call handlers are told they can only stay on the line for either life-threatening or the most serious incidents.
Okay, I need to hang up now to take another call, but the help has been arranged.
It's amazing how one job just knock us into emergency disconnect.
10 calls from members of the public generally indicates that it's going to be quite a significant RTC.
A vehicle's hit a lamppost. We think there's only one person involved, but they think he's trapped.
We can hear an ambulance.
Glyn and Andrea arrive in 3 minutes.
Well,
just to let you know, Helimed and an AP are running over.
I'm not sure we need Helimed, but I'll just let you know, okay? Okay, so see spine tenderness. Where's Glyn? I'm Andrea, sweetheart, right? I'm going to ask. No!
You need, that's it. You need Helimed to run.
Yeah. Do you remember what happened? No.
Thanks, Control Alpha 498. We're still taking obs, but this patient looks very poorly.
Can you keep Helimed running over?
Yeah, we'll keep Helimed running over.
Hiya, 7-2 are on the way to a RTC in Didsbury.
Just an update from the crew saying please keep them running, patient very poorly.
There's the main road, there's the ambulance.
Charlie, 7-2 is now overhead.
Hello, can you hear me? I need you to be really, really still because we have to protect your neck. His pulse is 67, Glyn.
Right.
Let me just get that blood pressure on him.
Yeah, it's all right, just stand him back a little bit, just give him a bit of space.
Glyn, he's got a low blood pressure, so I need to get a line in. Will you get me a green, please? I just need some kit, Glyn.
Hey?
I need some kit round here.
Well, breaking all convention. What's over here? Quite late, done.
Yeah.
Right.
So we need a flush, Glyn.
Yeah.
Hi, guys.
As an advanced paramedic, Gary's role is to take charge of the scene and coordinate all emergency services.
Just suggested like a quick grab and get out kind of thing. So, yeah, agreed. Cabriolet it, and then we'll get.
Can I just have a quick listen to his chest?
Of course you can. Yeah. Right, what's your buff? Yeah, roof off, please, if you can.
Guys, okay. Do you want this scene as it is now? Do you want to keep it all blocked off while you deal with the subject?
It would be handy if you could do.
Guided by you.
With the extent of the patient's injuries unknown, the air ambulance crew are equipped to provide an urgent medical assessment.
Andrew, when we start cutting, you're going to stay with him in the vehicle right there.
Okay.
No airbag, is there?
No, there's no airbag. He's got a good laceration above his right eye.
I know it's really, really noisy, but they're just cutting the roof off, so it's minimal movement for you.
How are his injuries? Is it serious?
I would say at the minute, the potential is that it is serious, yeah. We need to get him out quickly and then to a trauma centre, so.
Hello, are you okay? You get your head nice and still. We'll have you out in no time. Roof's off now.
With the patient now accessible, Helimed Dr. James can assess his condition.
Why is his blood pressure low? Not sure. I'm worried that his liver or his spleen have taken a big hit.
Yeah.
In which case, there's very little I can do other than tranexamic acid and go.
Is there any recall at all? What happened on him?
No, there's no idea.
No idea.
No idea. And we're going to move you, get you out, and then we can have a proper look at you on the ambulance. Just be, go easy with his chest.
Ready, brace, move.
He's on his right side.
Excellent.
Nice and gently down
there, guys. Thank you very much. I'm going to have a look at your chest with some cold jelly using an ultrasound machine. Very much like we used to look at pregnant ladies' bellies. Hopefully I won't find a baby in your chest. So a little bit of pressure there on your chest. I've got a rib there. Nice deep breath. Okay, got good evidence of lung sliding there. Pearls on a string. So you see, like, looks like what we call comet tails pointing downwards. So the lung is up on the right. Happy that you don't have a pneumothorax there. The decision really is, do we go MRI? Or Salford.
MRI's a lot closer than Salford.
He's got an obvious hole in his head and he's got a bullseye. I certainly think he's got more than enough excuse to warrant him being in a neurocentre rather than MRI.
Yeah.
Although the nearest A&E is 8 minutes away, the decision is made to go to Salford, a specialist neurocentre, which is a 20-minute drive on blue lights.
Salford,
Lisa. Hi, Salford, it's the trauma cell. Can I pass a trauma pre-alert, please? We have a 30-year-old male involved in an RTC. Query the mechanism of injury, but quite substantial damage to the car. There's a bullseye of the windshield and a bent steering wheel.
You shout me if you need anything. Do you remember what my name is?
What?
Andrea.
Okay.
Okay, you can shout anything you want, though. There you go, my friend. Is that better?
I've not done this job for long.
Do you know what day it is?
Saturday.
Saturday.
I come from the business sector. I managed a lot of people and I used to be very passionate and always on the go. And I remember coming home and I remember my husband at the time saying to me, for God's sake, this isn't a matter of life and death. But to me it was. And then I thought, well, what if it was? What if I did a job that I could give this amount of passion and enthusiasm and it actually did make a difference to people's lives?
What are you doing? You try and get your hands out. You feel sick? Just take some deep breaths. Are you okay? Are you going to be sick? Take some deep breaths.
Andrea, are you okay?
Tell me if you're gonna be sick. Okay, let me move that for a minute. Just take some deep breaths.
My head.
You can't move your head because it's in head blocks. Okay, deep breaths. Concentrate on your breathing for me. That's it. That's it, you're doing really, really well.
Bleeding
here. It's all clogged up now. You're not bleeding now. You did have a nosebleed, but it's gone.
The car.
The car? It's not good, mate, not good. Do you like convertibles? We ain't got a roof on it. All these things can be fixed. Just have to make sure you're all right.
How's he feeling?
He's great, he's having a good chat here.
Good. That's what we like to hear. Just about here.
Okay.
So Debbie, on that Didsbury RTC, he started coming round and he's going for a head scan and a chest scan now. But it should be a good outcome.